And Loretta, Modi has been on a charm offensive in different countries, trying to get foreign investment into India. When you look at certain sectors, what are most promising for you in terms of investment?
I still think FMCG, anything that's got a consumer durable mode in India, because you know, it's such a huge domestic economy. So anything that is driven back on itself by its own people. So FMCG, auto, certain parts of the IT industry, apps, new technologies that's coming in, because India is incredibly IT savvy. I think the only ones that you can sort of fault at the moment, obviously with oil, is the oil sector, some of the cap goods sector stocks and the power stocks. But you know, anything that's got a crude, sensitive handle, like some of these smaller airlines, Spice Air, Go Air, they've got a large potential at the moment.
Loretta, I want to ask you this question. I mean, I know you like the Indian markets, but I mean, talk to us about the risk-reward ratio as an investment case for that particular market in the context of the Fed that's in a transition phase of potentially hiking interest rates for next year.
Yeah, but they're two different beasts. I don't think you can put them anywhere close to each other. India has struggled for the last 10 years. She's coming back now into a cycle. I think what you see globally, you've got some benign global cues. She will take full advantage of this because she's got a domestic market that can fuel herself totally. So I mean, I think of an investment point of view from any foreigner, there'll be big infrastructure projects that the government will bring into the market. Yeah, there's a lot of easing. If some of the bureaucratic imbalances can be removed from India, then foreign investment will do particularly well, especially in the next 5 years. And you look at something, I think I read someone yesterday on the Sensex, you're looking at by the end of 2015, 32,500. That is definitely what's on the cards.
How could all the geopolitical polarisation that's going on at the moment affect India? I mean, obviously, we're starting to see China, Russia seeming to sort of move towards blocs. Where does India end up in those kind of games?
I think India does what India will do best. She will stand back and take decisions that are good for India. I mean, I don't think India has been particularly aggressive across any of the borders that she sits on, and I think that will continue. Modi will continue to be the diplomat that he showed us all that he can be in his last little trips around the world.
Loretta, we know you're quite bullish on India, but what do you see as the real challenges, say, in the next 5 years for the Modi government?
Well, I mean, the real challenge is he's got a population of over a billion people. Trying to channel anything decisive amongst those people is always a challenge to get them to think. Structurally, the bureaucracy. Everybody who ever has lived in India will tell you the biggest problem about India is the bureaucracy and corruption. Now, if just small steps, and I think Modi's certainly in the right direction of taking those, if the bureaucracy can be dismantled to make the machine function much better, as she will in India, then India will be one of the strongest places to invest in the world.